Okay, so let's go ahead and get started on the next one. This is Michal, and he's going to talk about Weblate. I'm saying that right?
Yeah, thanks. Hello, I'm Michal Čihař, and I'm author of a tool called Weblate, which can help you with localizing the software, or not only software, but any kind of project with my use for localization. Maybe let's start from the beginning. Do you know what localization and internationalization is? There are two things of the process. One part of the process is to make software available, possibility of using in different languages. That's called internationalization, or the shortcut with 18 in between, because it is a long and has plenty of letters on together. And the other part of the process is localization, which actually does the translation itself of the software. So you need to be first prepared for that. And then you can use some tooling to make it possible. There are a lot of frameworks make it possible to localize, and Weblate tries to be framework agnostic. So whatever you use on your platform, be it Android application, it has native support for localization, or iOS things, or web app extension localization, or get text, Weblate can use all of that. But we need people to do the localization. And working with the people is sometimes hard, because they have different knowledge, different backgrounds, and you need to make it easy for them to contribute. Especially if you are focusing on languages which are not that widely used, there are minor communities, and you will not find technically skilled people to contribute to the translations. And at the same time, it's needed to provide translators context so that they know what they are translating. There are a lot of words which can have different meanings depending on the context. The favorite example is the name of the closest star, which is the sun. If you just look at the text, you will probably figure out that it's this name. But if you will just solely see these three letters, it can be as well a shortcut for a Sunday. And if you don't know where this thing is being used, you will mess it up in the translation, because it's not that easy to figure out just from this thing. So that's something what tools should make it easy to to the contributors. At Weblate, we have made in the beginning one design choice, and that's that we will use web interface to make localization really easy for everybody to contribute. That means that translators don't have to care what's underneath. They don't have to care that there's some Git version control and there's pull requests being opened with the translations and whatever the developers actually would like to have. So it's done on the tooling side, and Weblate tries to hide as much as possible from the translators. The other thing we have decided is the version control integration. That was one of the main reasons why Weblate actually started in the beginning, because there was no other localization framework we would integrate with the version control system. Now there might be some options possible, but in that time it was the only one. And we started really with simple integration, that whenever somebody edited single string, it made a commit, and that led to thousands of commits, and it wasn't really working well. So over the years we have developed something which works more clever and tries to do commits only when needed, and can do pull requests with GitHub and similar additions. I've already mentioned about context. One of the things which might be useful is just describe where this thing is used. That helps in the thing like the star and Sunday I've mentioned before. But there might be more useful things to add. For example, if you get at a screenshot context, then even if the people are not that technically skilled, they can see where this thing is used, they can see other buttons on the page, and can understand what is being used. But still, people will make mistakes, and the tool should be able to figure out that they have made some mistakes that are easy to fix or easy to spot. So we have some kind of quality checks, and these are focused on things which are to some degree certainly detectable, so that we don't annoy people that much. It's like missing format strings, broken HTML markup, or similar topics, or things which are actually enforced from the localization, from the developer side, like length of the string or space in which it should be rendered. And not everybody fits the same workflow, so in the end we have came up with add-ons to customize the workflow. It can help you, it can make you change the way the localization format is stored, or it can customize how you accept the translations. You can have some review process, you can have voting for suggestions, all these minor details that make possible to work within different scenarios. And how can you start with using Weblate? You can start your own instance. It's just Docker image, which you can start with Docker Compose and get it in running quite fast. You can use also our hosted service, which has free tier for Libra software, or if you are looking for some commercial localization, we can do that as well. And let's take a quick look how it looks like. I hope the screenshot will work fine. When creating a project, basically the most important thing you need to define is source code repository. Weblate will connect to that. Will present you set of localizable files which has found in the repository. So we have some choices here. There are some Android localization. It's our demo project. It's not probably something real you will see, but it's just to have some more choices. So it has different file formats. It detected where the files are stored. And when you import it, they show up in the interface. You can see the status of individual translations into individual languages. So we can see the only complete language is source language, which is English. That's because we always track all source strings as well. That's quite recent change. If you were looking at older versions before, it was not present there, but it was tracked in underneath anyway, and now it's just more visible. And for the old translations, you can see some colorful progress bars which indicate different states of the string. The green one is translated, then there are some strings needing action, or the yellow ones that indicate some health checks. You can look into the sum of the translated string, or actually not translated string. You can see the quite simple user interface. The most important thing is you can actually enter the translation, and you can see other information which Weblate has figured out about the string. This is the way the project was imported from the PO files. So you don't see much additional information here. There is which translation file is there. There is source code where it was extracted by the text. And you can see you can add screenshots, add some additional context here. And there is a glossary on top, which is also empty right now. The other thing which we have is quality checks. This is again, as it was imported, so it's things which are built in and don't need any configuration. And there are some things which can be configured as well. So the most interesting thing is the Python formats thing. It is the check that indicates that the translation is missing formats thing. You can see it's highlighted in the source, and it's missing from the check translation, so that indicates some severe problem in the translation. It's highlighted like this. It's listed in the things to check on the right sidebar, so that it's really visible, and you can dismiss it if you think it's false positive. Actually, you can fix that. There's also indication that percent S is missing in this thing here. And that's pretty much all I wanted to show in this short demo. If you want to figure out more, there will be a longer talk later today at 5 p.m. in coding for language communities. I will go in more details there. If you want to chat with us in less formal way, you can join us for a beer today evening. And there's also Weblate both tomorrow and lunch, where we will discuss with project using Weblate and going into more details about some way how we want to develop Weblate later. So thanks for your attention, and do you have any questions?
Annotations or like what is used in Android?
Xlib and Android are quite different beasts. With Android, the thing is that it doesn't, the format itself isn't really well defined behavior in XML. So whenever there is some markup, it tries to use it as a markup, but if it's not a valid markup, then it still does something. But we try to display the markup as is for the translation, so that people can do the original thing which was intended there. The similar thing which is with Xlib, we support the Xlib placeholders, and they are imported as XML and shown as XML in the interface.
And C data, is that the problem?
C data is probably won't be preserved as bit counted as in Weblate, so it will be passed as data. And on saving, I don't think we will. See data.
Guess we have time for one more, I think.
I would like to integrate the Weblate into our build workflow. And are there some API that can be called to say to Weblate, or from Weblate to say to our Jenkins environment, this is full by the side of the translations?
We have Weblate has REST API, so we can control most of the things. It's not yet complete that you would be able to do all the things which you are able to do in the UI, but most of the things can be done on the API. You can also use some webhooks notification to let Weblate know that there are some changes in your upstream repo. We have support most of the code hosting services. And for letting the other side know, there's currently only support for doing things like pull requests or pushing to the Git repository or Git review, but we don't have any outside hooks right now.
Okay. Okay, so
but you can always write your add-ons to integrate with that. That's just few lines of Python, and you can do your customization that way as well.
So there's a way when, for example, an editor approve the translation, or something else approve the translations, to say to the CI or whatever, the translation are done correctly.
Yeah, that would have to be integrated with some other item that's currently not supported directly.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.